Welcome to this instruction video. In this video, I'll show you a design of myself, the little star rainbow blanket. Let's go start.
We start with a color yarn with a magic circle. And make that circle a little bit small. That's not too big to work in it. We start with a chain two. One. And two, and now we make a puff stitch in that magic circle. Yarn over, go with your hook in that circle, pick up your yarn and pull up a loop. That's one. Yarn over, go back in that same circle and pull up a loop. That's two. Once more, yarn over, go in that circle and pull up. Now yarn over and pull through all those loops that you pull up, but not on that stitch on the hook. Two loops left on your hook, yarn over and pull through to close that puff stitch. Make a chain one for a straight edge. Now we work another puff stitch in that magic circle. Yarn over and pull up a loop. Yarn over, pull a loop, yarn over, pull a loop, yarn over, pull through the loops, but not on that stitch on the hook, two loops left on your hook, yarn over, pull through two. Now we make a corner, chain two, one and two, that's a corner. Now we work three more times two puff stitches in that magic circle. Pull up a loop once, pull up a loop twice, and pull up a loop three times. Yarn over, pull through that loops, yarn over, pull through two. Now make a chain one for a straight edge in a circle and puff stitch. It's one, two, three loops, yarn over, pull through the loops. Yarn over, pull through two. Now make a corner, chain two. One and two for a corner. Two more to go. And puff stitch in that circle. It's one, two, three times. Pull through, yarn over, pull through two. Make a chain one for a straight edge. If you circle is a little bit too big, then pull a little bit on the thread of your magic circle that is closing a little bit. Make a puff stitch. One, two, and three. And close the puff stitch and make a corner. Chain two. One and two. Two puff stitches to go. It's one, two, and three. Close and chain one for a straight edge. One puff stitch to go. It's one, two, three times. Yarn over, pull through two to close the puff stitch. And now we make our last corner and chain two. One and two. Pull on that little tail of that magic circle and then the ring is closed. To close this round, you go to the first stitch above that first puff stitch. Go in with your hook on the top and make a slip stitch to close this round. Make a chain and pull up a little loop and you can cut off the yarn. Weave this still in on the back of your work. The color white is on my hook and I begin with a standing double crochet in any corner space, and that's a chain two corner space, and the last chain two corner space that we made is for that little knot here. in that space, I'm working a standing double crochet. The yarn is on my hook, yarn over, and go in that chain two corner space, pick up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over, pull through two for a standing double crochet. In that same space, and double crochet, yarn over, go in that same space, pick up a loop, and yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. Chain two, one and two, and go back in that same chain two corner space with another two double crochet. That's one, and go back in that same space, two, and this is your first corner. Now go over that first puff stitch, and then in the next chain one space we work three double crochets and work around those little tail here. Go in that next chain one space, three double crochets in that same space. One, two, and three. Skip over the next puff stitch, and now we work in that next chain two space, a new corner. Two double crochets in that chain two corner space. That's one. And two, make a chain two, one and two, and go back in that same corner space with another two double crochets, one and two for a second corner. Skip over to the next space in that chain one space from straight edge, three double crochets in that space. It's one, two, and three. Now in the next chain two corner space, a new corner, two double crochets and chain two, and two double crochets in that same space. Skip over to the next chain one space and work three double crochets in that same space. It's one, two, and three. Now our last corner in that next chain two space, two double crochets in that space, and chain two, and two double crochets in that same space. In our last chain one space, a straight edge, three double crochets in that same space. For closing this round, we go to the first standing double crochet, and then on the top of that standing double crochet, go in with your hook and make a slip stitch. In the next round, we use the same color. In round three, with the same color, we begin with a chain three. One, two, and three. And this counts for a double crochet. In the next stitch, and that's the stitch four, and chain two corner space, we work a double crochet and work around that little tail. In that last stitch for that corner space, a double crochet. In that chain two corner space, we make a new corner. Two double crochets in that space. That's one and two. Make a chain two, one and two, and go back in that same corner space with another two double crochets. It's one and two. Now in the next seven stitches, we work on the top of each stitch a double crochet, and your first stitch is here in that double crochet after that chain two corner space. That's the first stitch. That's one, and go to the next stitch, two, and in the next, three, and in the next, four, and five, six, and seven. In the next chain two corner space, we work a new corner, two double crochets, and chain two, and two double crochets in that same corner space. And this is the same corner than the first corner. Work all those stitches after that corner here all the way around, and then I'll show you how you can close this round. I'm almost round. I made the last corner. Now on the last five stitches we work a double crochet. It must be seven. In the beginning we work a chain three, that counts for a double crochet, and then in the next stitch also a double crochet, and that makes seven double crochets in total. So in the next five stitches a double crochet. That's one, two, three, four, five, and this is six, and this is seven. Now we cut the yarn and we open up that stitch. Pull up your hook all the way up, and then with a needle we make an invisible join to close this round. That first chain three stitches, we skip those stitches. We never work an invisible join in the first chain stitches or standing stitch. We go always to the second stitch, and that's the real first double crochet here on the top. Go in with your hook in the top of that stitch, under through that V stitch, from the front to the back, and then pull through. Now we're working around that first chain three stitches. Now go back with your needle in the last double crochet that you made, then under the top, on only in the back loop, go in with your needle and pull through. And this is your invisible join. Leave those still in on the back of your work, and then we begin with the next color. In round four, I put the color back on my hook where we make that puff stitches with. And we begin in a chain two corner space with a standing half double crochet. Yarn is on my hook, yarn over, and go in that chain two corner space, pick up a loop, three loops on your hook, yarn over, and pull through all the three loops for a standing half double crochet. In that same corner space we work four half double crochets in that same space. Yarn over, go with your hook in that same space, pick up your thread, three loops on your hook, yarn over, and pull through three loops. That's one. Go back in that same corner space. Two. And three. And once more. Four. A corner of five half double crochets. In the next three stitches, around the next three stitches, we work a back post double crochet. Yarn over and go with your hook in that corner space from the back to the front, and then work around that first double crochet. Go back from the front to the back, and then on the back of your work pick up a thread and pull through, and that first one can a little bit hard. Three loops on your hook, yarn over, pull to two, yarn over, put with two. Now you see here on the front a little loop around that first double crochet. Yarn over, go to the next double crochet, from the back to the front, from the front to the back, around that double crochet, pick up your thread, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. Once more, in the next, around the next double crochet, and back post double crochet. In the next 5 stitches, we work a half double crochet. Yarn over, go to the next stitch. And half double crochet. It's 1, and go to the next stitch. 2, and in the next. 3, 4, and in the next is 5 half double crochets. On the next 3 double crochets, around the next 3 double crochets, we work a back post double crochet. Let's go around the next double crochet on the back and back post double crochet. That's 1, and go around the next stitch. 2, and around the next 3. In that chain 2 corner space, 5 half double crochets in that same corner space for a new corner. That's 1, go back in that same stitch, 2, 3, 4, and 5, all in that same corner space. This is the same corner than the first corner. Repeat all the stitches after that first corner 3 more times and make an invisible join in the beginning. My last 3 back post double crochets. I'm done with all the stitches. Cut the yarn and open up that stitch, pull up a loop all the way up, and then make an invisible join, and then we're done with the square. We skip that first stitch, go to the next stitch, on the front to the back, pull through, then go back to the last back post double crochet, and then only in the back loop, go in with your needle, pull through, and work those tails in on the back of your work. The first square that I made is a soft yellow square, and then I made 2 yellow squares, and then 3 light green squares, and 4 dark green squares, and 5 squares, and then the most squares is the purple one, and that's 10 squares, and then we decrease the squares, and 9 squares of the lilac and 8 squares of the light purple, and then I made some squares here on the next corner. I'm done with making all the squares for the blanket. If you want your blanket bigger, then you have to make more squares in more colors. Now we're joining all the squares together. Now I took the first 2 rows of the crown, and that's this row and the second row, and I place it on my table. I take the 2 first rows to my table, and what we're going to do now, we take the first 2 squares on the right. And we fold these 2 squares together, the good side on the good side. Flip over. And we're going to start to joining these squares. Here are my two first squares facing together. And now I have two stitch markers and we put that stitch marker in the first square on the right, in the third stitch in the corner, and that's the center stitch of that 5 half double crochets in that corner that you made. It's 1, 2, and 3. Now it's 1, 2, and 3. That's the stitch in the third stitch, and then only in the back loop of the stitch you see here the whole stitch, that V stitch, and this is the front loop and this is the back loop of that stitch, and only in the back loop on this way you put that stitch marker in. In the square on the table, in the next corner on the right, in the third half double crochet, and that's the center stitch of this square, it's 1, 2, 1, 2, and 3. That's that stitch, and then only in the back loop, this is the whole stitch, and then only in the back loop place that stitch marker in. Also on the other side, search the center stitch, 3, that's the center stitch, only in the back loop, and also on the square on the table, 1, 2, 3, that's the center stitch, only in the back loop, place that stitch marker in. Now with the hook, with the white color, a slip knot is on my hook, and we start with a standing single crochet in that first stitch where we put that stitch marker in. Go with your hook in that corner space and in the corner space of the second square. Pick up your thread and yarn over and pull through. Now go to the next stitch, and then only in the back loop of that stitch, this is the whole stitch and this is only the back loop, and also in the other square this is the whole stitch, but we need only to make a single crochet in the back loop and make a single crochet in the next stitch, only in the back loop. And in the next square, only in the back loop, make a single crochet. In every stitch, only in the back loop. From corner stitch to corner stitch, make only in the back loop a single crochet stitch. Like this. And work not too tight. In every stitch in the back loop, a single crochet, and that to the next corner. Two stitches to go, that's the last stitch for the corner stitch, and then the last stitch in the stitch of that stitch marker, the last single crochet only in the back loop. Now we remove that stitch marker. And this one also. We cut not the yarn, we go right to the next two squares. I fold this open. And now this is the next two squares. And we fold facing down together. Like this. And we put a stitch marker in the two corners. And also in the next two corners. I put the next two stitch markers in. And then in the first corner of the next two squares. On the stitch marker. In that stitch. We go in with the hook. And make a single crochet only in the back loop. In the next two stitches, only in the back loop, and only in the back loop, a single crochet. And that we do to the next corner. Make all the stitches. I make all my stitches, and when we make those squares open, you see here all those little stitches between the two squares. And on the back, you see those single crochets. My first four squares are done. This is the next two squares. I fold it together. Good side on the good side. And place the stitch markers in. And now we work with the same yarn from corner to corner, only in the back loop. With a single crochet, and then I have here 2 times 7 squares. Fold it all together and work from corner to corner all those stitches to the end. I'm on the end of my first row, and we make on the end 1 chain stitch and pull up a loop and cut the yarn. The first two rows are now together. And if we fold it open, we have this. Take the next row from the ground and bring it here to my table. These are the squares of my third row. And now when you grab that first square and you put it on the table, now we fold the two squares on this way together and place a stitch marker in both corners of both squares. Then we make only in the back loop a single crochet from corner to corner. And grab the next square. Fold your work together. Place a stitch marker in both corners. And make from corner to corner, only in the back loop, single crochets. Make all the rows with the single crochets to the blanket. Now we work the horizontal lines, and then we work the vertical lines. I'll show you when you get done with all the horizontal lines, how you make the vertical lines, and how you skip over the first single crochets of the horizontal lines.
I'm done with joining all the squares on the horizontal line. Now we must joining all the squares on the vertical line. What you're doing now is turn your work and start all over again. Fold your squares together face to face on the good side and start in the first corner stitch. And make all those stitches on the back of your work only in the back loop. And then I show you how you skip over to the next two squares.
I'm turned my work and I fold the squares together like this. And I start in the first corner stitch here and make all those stitches. I must make one more stitch for the corner stitch. That's the last stitch for the corner stitch. And now we have here the corner. And in that corner you work in the horizontal line and single crochet in the back loop. Now you work for the second time another single crochet in that same corner space. Dus two loops, corner loops, and make a single crochet. Now we must skip over to the next two corners. In the next two corners, you see that you make in the horizontal line also a single crochet. Go back in that same two corner spaces with another single crochet. And then in the next two stitches only in the back loop, you work a single crochet. And that is how you cross over to the next two squares. Make all those stitches and skip over the next line of that single crochets and work in the single crochet in the corner, a single crochet, and skip over the single crochets and in the next two corners for a second time a single crochet. We make a border around this blanket. I have the white color back on my hook and we start with a standing double crochet in any stitch. In that whole stitch, a double crochet, standing double crochet. Work in every stitch a double crochet. And now here in the corner stitch, that's the third double crochet here in the corner of your square, we make a two double crochets, this one and two, make a chain one, and then back in that same corner stitch with two double crochets, one and two for a new corner. And then in every stitch a double crochet. Make all those stitches and then I show you how you work here to the next square. I'm done with all those stitches, and now we came on the point that two squares meet each other. What we're going to do now is we work in the right square in the corner stitch and double crochet. And now we work in the same corner stitch and the next corner stitch, two double crochets together. Yarn over and go back in that same corner stitch of the right square. Pick up your thread, yarn over and pull through two. Yarn over and skip to the next square in the corner stitch and make a double crochet, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, three loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through three loops. Now you made here two double crochets together. In that same corner stitch of the left square, you work another double crochet in that same corner stitch. And now in every stitch a double crochet. Work so all the way around, make all your stitches, and then I'll show you how we make the border complete. And in every corner stitch of the blanket, two double crochets in that corner stitch, one and two, and chain one, and two double crochets in that same corner stitch. And then in every stitch a double crochet. Goes all the way around. I made all the stitches all the way around. My last double crochet. Now we cut the yarn. And open up the stitch. And with a needle we make an invisible join in the beginning. The first standing double crochet, we skip that stitch. We go always to the next stitch and then on the top of that first wheel double crochet, on the through that V-stitch, from the front to the back, and pull through, you work around that first standing double crochet, go back to the last double crochet that you made, and then on the top, only in the back loop, then pull through, and this is your invisible join. Leave that tail in on the back of your work. Color white is back on my hook, and we make the last round of this blanket. We make all the way around picot stitches. We begin in a J1 corner space with a standing single crochet. And we make the first picot. Make a chain three. One, two, three. And now go back on the top of that first standing single crochet on the top stitch here. Go in with your hook and that little stitch next to it. Now you have three loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all the three loops for complete and picot. In the next stitch, and that's the first double crochet stitch after that chain one corner space, we work one single crochet. In the next stitch, we make a new picot, a single crochet, make a chain three, one, two, three, go back on the top of that single crochet and that little loop next to it. Pick up your thread, pull through, and pull through. In the next stitch, a single crochet. And in the next stitch, we work a new picot. A single crochet, a chain three, and make a slip stitch on the top, and a little stitch here, a slip stitch to make that picot complete. in the next stitch a single crochet, and in the next stitch a new picot, a single crochet, and chain 3, and a slip stitch on the top of that single crochet. Make all those picot stitches all the way around, and in the corner space you work in that chain 1 space 1 picot stitch, and then in the beginning, in that standing single crochet, you make an invisible join to close this round, and then we're done. It's my last picot stitch. And now in the first standing single crochet, we make that invisible join, cut your yarn, and open up that stitch. Here in the beginning is your first standing single crochet. We skip that stitch, and then in the next stitch, and that's under that chain 3 loop space of that picot stitch, where you make that slip stitch, go in with your needle front to the back in that space here of that slip stitch, and work around the first standing single crochet. Go back to the last single crochet that you made on the top in the back loop, pull through, and this is your invisible join. Leave the tails in on the back of your work, and we're done with the blanket. The little star rainbow blanket is done. Thank you for watching, and see you next time. Bye.